so uptight, but my heart's been hurt a couple times by a couple guys that didn't treat me right. I ain't gonna lie. Hey guys, it's Girl Monet, back with another video. Shout out to my lovelies who are sticking by me, supporting me, commenting, everything. Love y'all. Have a good life. Okay, so this video is going to be a story time video about my first relationship. Oh my god, guys! I know you're probably like, your first relationship, how old are you? I'm 21. I know. I'm a late bloomer. So yeah, basically how it all started was met this guy in the gym. Thought he was kind of cute, but wasn't really gonna say anything. Then he messaged me on Snapchat. Yeah, because we exchanged Snapchat because he was supposed to have a party or something. I don't know, but anyways, that happens. We exchanged Snapchat, we talked. We went on our date, our first date, which was at the movies. We went to go see Isn't It Romantic? It's a very, very good movie. But looking back on it, that movie is about basically her concluding that she just needs to love herself for who she is. Because, she felt like she needed a guy to love him, and she was missing out on all that, but she realized, I need to love me first before I can love anybody else. And you know what? I kind of had that same realization myself. I don't know. I would let the little things bother me a lot. I let them get under my skin. And I just came to the conclusion of I don't give two motherfuckers. Yeah. So I just came to that conclusion. Because I just feel like if you ain't saying it to my face, then it is irrelevant. I am not going to give it any time of the day anymore. And that's what I've been doing. So yeah, but anyways, back to the story. So yeah, we went on our first date. It was actually, to me, it was actually a really good first date. I was very shy and a little awkward, but the good thing about a first date was just that we were the only ones in the theater, which made it even better because we were able to talk and watch the movie, and he held my hand, and I thought it was something. And so after that, we start hanging out almost every day, and we went on a picnic. He bought some drinks, I bought some food, I bought the blanket. I mean, yeah, wouldn't you think that would be a relationship? You guys are hanging out so much, da 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 da, you asked me on a date. I mean, But anyways, so basically, we hang out, he meets some of my friends, he has to ride the bike in the rain to my house, because, my friend can, put his bike in the car. I don't know, I just know he has to ride the bike there, and we hung out there, she gave him food, everything was pretty cool. We did the best of what we could, because, yeah. Anyway, so we did that, and then I want to say a few weeks we break up, and we called it off again last night. He's saying all these things to me. I guess I kind of understand that. Okay, because I didn't even call you during the whole week. I guess I understand that. I talked to my friends about it, and they were kind of why are you inviting me? I don't know, he's just why are you inviting me somewhere when you haven't talked to me the whole week? And, I just felt it wasn't my duty to necessarily call and text him every day. I told you on Monday at the beginning of the week. And, I don't know, I just felt it goes both ways type of thing. So, I felt maybe other girls are calling you and texting you every moment of the day, but that ain't me. But anyways, so we kind of got into it, had a conversation. He called me so many different things, delusional, ungrateful. What else did he say? It's a while ago, and I don't even have the text anymore. The moral is that he called me so many different things, and then he told me that don't ever talk to him again, which was kind of immature because I was just like, if you want to have a conversation, we can talk at school and talk it out, you know? So things won't be so awkward and weird between us, but he wasn't feeling that. So anyways, that is not the end of the story. There is more. So basically, like, he's acting pretty standoffish, working at the gym at the time. And I think he talks to one of my friends instead of actually coming to me. Like, is Monet spreading shit about me? Spreading mad shit about you. No, we just went out for like 2 weeks. No, why would I do that? And I don't know, it made me feel shit about me. Like, talking shit about me behind my back. Like, yeah. I don't know, but anyways, I am not the type of person to talk shit behind somebody's back. If I have a problem, I will say it to your face. Just the way I am. But anyways, yeah, I just kind of got upset. I'm like, what? Why is he talking to you and not to me? Like, be a man about it and come to the source. Like, yeah. But anyways, that didn't happen. And we were just being awkward and very weird about it. I don't know. I don't really know. But anyways, he ended up messaging me like a month later, because like we start dating March 10th. You probably don't even know that, but we started dating March 10th, and I believe it was a Sunday. But anyways, yeah. So we started dating March 10th, and then like I want to say April 12th is when he messaged me back. So, I mean, a little less than a month, but still almost a month. He messages me because we went out for 2 weeks during that time. But, yeah, like, he messages me. He's just like, I miss you. And, I mean, my dumb self. My dumb self. I was like, I miss you too. I know. It's just a learning experience. Like, I know I'm not dumb, but... Yeah, it's like, I miss you too. Like, I was just so, like, into it. And, I don't know, like, we talk and everything. He writes, like, paragraphs how much I mean to him. I mean, it's just very confusing, you know? It's, like, very confusing for a guy to keep coming in and out of your life and writing paragraphs about how much they like you and want to be with you. But then it's, like, you guys still end up breaking up. Over and over and over again. So it's like, I don't know, like, me and my friend, we had a double date and stuff, and it was cool. Like, we hung out, we talked. He was telling me the things, like, I don't know, I felt like a little bit personal, or like, I don't know, like a little vulnerable things that he was telling me. Like, I felt like he was trying to be a better person. I thought, fooled me, right? Anyways, I felt like he was trying to be a better person, and I don't know, I was willing to work it out and stuff. Willing to work it out. She basically blew me off. I guess I don't know. On again, off again. I'm not with that. And I think I only entertain that because I like him and thought. Thought wrong. But yeah. I mean, I don't know, I'm the person who wants to be the best with everyone. And I guess I give them a chance. Because I cannot give them any more chances. You know, like, if you're doing the same thing over and over and over and over again, eventually it's gonna get old. It's gonna get real old. So anyways, like, he messaged me while I'm on vacation, and I don't know, I was a little conflicted because I'm conflicted with the fact that you're my first relationship, I like you, but you are fickle. You are fickle. Like, 1 minute, you're mine, or at least I think you're mine, and then the next minute, you're ghosting me. So it just makes me feel like, it made me feel like, okay, like, since I'm not giving him sex, he's probably gonna get me somewhere else. That's how it made me feel. But I remember when we talked, he was saying we could take it slow, blah, blah, blah. Like, I don't know, I just feel like he wasn't straightforward and wasn't honest, you know? Or, like, maybe he wasn't. relationship, but I don't know exactly. Like, I feel like he wants to be a good guy, but he doesn't want, or like, he wanted me, but like, he doesn't want to put in the effort to actually keep me, you know? And I don't know, I just can't get over that. It's like, I don't know, like, I'm not asking for much out of a guy, but I want trust and I want loyalty. I want an actual bond, you know, before I reward you with what you really want. So, yeah, I need to know that you can actually be there for me, you know? And if you can't wait for that, then you ain't the one. You are not the one for me, honey. Don't care how sexy or how whatever you have, how rich. Don't really care about that. Because, I mean, I want somebody to treat me right. And love me for me. And pretty much love only me. Don't be loving on other people at the same time. So, yeah. In California, on my vacation. And, I don't know, he was just like, oh, I like your new hair and blah, 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 and everything. So I guess he was watching my snaps. Yeah, and I know he says a lot of stuff. And then I think I asked him, do you know what you really want? Or I forgot. I have to look at the text, and right now I can't do that. But it was just like, and I asked him a question. I think it took him like an hour or two, or maybe more, to respond. Because I guess he was trying to come up with a good answer. You know, I think about it, whatever, and he's like, oh, are you gonna come visit me when you're back, babe, blah, blah, blah. Do you miss me? You miss me, hun? And I'm like, do you miss me? And he's like, yeah. But anyways, like, I guess I just was thinking, like, you could have said happy birthday to me. Like, I don't know, I feel like I put in some effort of actually trying to get to know him. Like, for instance, when we were on a date, he was just like, oh, my favorite song is You Owe Me by the Chainsmokers. He enjoys swimming and stuff. He was a swimmer. I know some things, like, he told me about, like, where he lived. Like, he used to live in Sherman Oaks growing up. I don't know. I pay attention to detail, and I try to listen to what some people say and pick up on things to get to know them better. I don't really know if he knows or if he even remembers any of the things I told him. But you know what I realized? I know this is kind of going off a different topic, but it, like, he didn't want to tell me when he graduated. Like, yeah, he graduated, I think he graduated high school 2017. And I was asking this question because, I don't know, like, I just want to make sure you are of age. Because I think at that time I was 20, gonna be 21, and I didn't want to be dating a 17-year-old. So I'm just like, tell me when you graduated. Because, I mean, I don't know. I feel like I won't date anybody under the age of 18 because, just because, like, statutory rape type of thing. And also because I'm just a little bit older than them. They're kind of still in that high school mindset. And I'm not in that anymore. But anyways, yeah. So he was not 17. He was not under the age of 18. He was, I want to say he was 19. He was 19, I was 20, so we were only a year apart, so that was no problem. But yeah, anyways, back on topic. So yeah, he messaged me in August, and I forgot a key point. I had messaged him before I officially, like, was, like, done. I was like, can you tell me if you're cheating on me or not? Because I don't want to waste my time. Be like, like, LOL. He said LOL, and I was just like, I'm being totally serious. This is not a joke right now. And I think that was the last I heard from him. And, like, I seen him, he was at parties, he was at other things. And basically, when he called me, and we talked, my stupid self answers the phone. But, you know, anyways, we talked eventually after me ignoring him for a long, long time. And I guess it was getting under his skin. Because he was just, like, really mad about it. So, So like I called, I mean he called me. I couldn't have to spill it out to him because I was just like, if you want to talk to me, I don't owe you to call you. If you want to know what's in my brain, you should call me. Basically, and he called me, we talked, and what happened? I was really upset at him. Like I just was very mad, really, really upset. Like he was like, "Oh, why are you raging? Blah blah blah." And then LOL, I never say LOL. Right there, listening to that, that was a red flag right there because, or like he was being a hypocrite because LOL, you said LOL in our first text when we got into an argument. You're being very like condescending. You're like LOL, like oh my god, you're so funny. But yeah, you said that, and you said LOL multiple times in text, so you don't know what you'd be saying. Like honestly, like know what you say. Say what you mean. But obviously, he was just like, oh, I don't say LOL. I don't know what you're talking about. And I didn't have a screenshot to prove it, but I didn't have to prove shit because I already knew. And like he was telling me, I was like, how come you couldn't call me or whatever? He's like, oh, my phone broke or something, and I was sharing my sister's phone, blah blah blah. And I'm like, how are you on Snapchat? And then he's like, we have a shared account. Like, I don't know. He's just telling me all shit. Like, I honestly don't know if there's such thing as shared accounts with Snapchat. I don't think there is. I just made one this year, but I didn't see anything about shared account. Like, what the fuck is that? Anyways, yeah, he was feeding me all this. I was kind of seeing right through it. Like right through it. And I just wasn't feeling it. And then I think we got off the phone, and then he's like, oh, you know what, I'm not really thinking straight right now, I'm just a little drunk. I'll call you when my mind is clear. And I'm just like, you make no sense at all, man. You make no sense at all. I don't know, but that happens. And I ignore the hell out of him, and he sees me on campus the first day of school, and my natural attitude is to be happy and cool and whatever. So when somebody taps me, I'm just like, hey, and then I see it's him, and I'm just like, go somewhere with that. But anyway, so yeah, like I kind of start ignoring him, and then I guess he feels like he's actually losing me this time, so he kind of stops trying to get me back. And we go to this party. I go to the party on Sunday. He happens to be there. I get invited by a mutual friend in our group, so that's why I went. And it was some craziness going on. I'm not gonna go into all detail about exactly what happened, but it was some craziness. He eventually leaves, so nothing really happened, and it's probably for the best anyways, but like I don't know, even when somebody told me though that he was coming, I wasn't gonna let that stop me from having a good time. So, yeah. But anyways, yeah, I had a good time at the party until like somebody tells me that this is so stupid. But I got mad because somebody told me that he was having sex with 37 different girls in different positions and everything. And I mean, the number was probably exaggerated, I'm pretty sure, but I don't know, the fact of the matter was just that no matter how many girls you were doing it with, you were trying to get back with me at the time, you know. That made me feel like, it made me feel like craziness, like yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna be wrapping this video up. No need for searching, never let us say.